when you see our teachers teaching the students using interactive board, because that is one of the major things that make us smart. So with this board, you can take the students in different dimensions and teach them learning.
Board interactive board is because the board has different features. We have, like, for instance, the teacher can possibly take the children to YouTube channel and show them what is happening. The teacher can as well go back to notes. This is notes where she's working. The teacher can add, get a new note and start writing in the note. How can you write in this note? Because the children are little children and they like colors. The teacher can possibly play with colors while teaching them. You can just pick different types of pen, like English. The teacher can decide to change the color to red. And as a case like that, the teacher can also search. The teacher can go directly to the internet and search, get content that is very essential. This interactive board is very essential because it makes teaching and learning more realistic, relevant, entertaining and fun. You see the students coming out to work in line with the teachers. We have physics, chemistry, and biology. So the first, these two, is for physics. Then the second phase is for chemistry. Then the last one is for biology. So we have different components that the children need to use.
We're using here is HP with Core i microprocessor, and we have other softwares that we're using to teach the children. We have 40 capacity system here. We have 40 here and 40 in e-library. So basically we are planning to start a CBT exam system so that students will start getting accustomed with that. Yes. So this is our ICT lab, yes.
here is Digital Creativity Hub. In this Digital Creativity, our teachers and students work. These are projects. The students are working. This is called Arduino Kit. This kit is basically what we're using to create different projects, smart projects. So with this Arduino kit, we have different parts. So students can, on their own, handle this and use it to teach. Also try to teach our students basic technology, so the issue of repair of our devices will be handled by the students.
Wow.
Because we want to be conscious of that, not just to teach them other things. We also let them know that they can also repair already existing technology. This is called oscillopsis, and this is functional generator. These are two powerful machines that we can use for mechatronics. And with this machine, we can drill our students to know how to check a vehicle, diagnose vehicles, because you find out that mechanics are already messing a lot of things up.
True.
So with this knowledge, our students can diagnose vehicles and know what is wrong with the vehicle first. With this thing, we can be manufacturing things. You can see what we have started printing. This is our work. So our target for this work is to print robotic arm. We're trying to print robotic arm that we can use to lift up something and take down. So, and before we start this, we need to design first, and after the design, we send to 3D printing. And because this is very essential, it has a dedicated solar. The difference between this and normal printer is that normal printer is using toner, but this is using this filament. Filament is made with plastic, and we're also looking forward that in no distant time, we'll be producing filaments here. This place we are here is called Imagination Hub. The second one is Digital Creativity Hub. And the third one is Mechatronics Hub. They have different skills. And when students come in here, they start with ideation. They start with creativity. They create something. They put heads together and come up with a prototype. And in this Imagination Hub, we engage our students with virtual reality headsets. We teach them how to use this. Okay, now this is a virtual reality headset. Currently, I am trying to set up where to start on the space. I can virtually take you to a virtual tour of the space. I'll take you to Mount Everest. I'll take you to aviation, where you can see a pilot flying the cockpit. Is to go to industries and use this 360 camera to generate content, because the major challenge we face in education today is the gap between the industry and classroom. So with this, you can go to a factory and generate content, step-by-step procedures on production. With that step-by-step procedures, we can now put the soft copy here and the students will look at it and we cast it in our interactive board. It makes teaching and learning more realistic and relevant.
Children, their various talents. Some are very good with playing the drums and other instruments like the bass, guitar, the violin, the piano. Some are good in singing. We also have specialists that train them in voice, where their voices are trained how to sing. So this is where what they do, where they are trained on those areas.
You can see the camera points.
So from this room you monitor the entire school?
Yes.
Alright.
When you see students loitering outside from here, you tell them to move in back to the classes. Here. Yes.
Mm. Alright.
So we see everything that is happening anywhere you are.
Okay. Mm.
The ICT lab, the digital library.
Okay.
This is the frontage of the school.
Okay.
And then the back setting. So because we notice that we need water here, we have a water purification plant here. Coming from the smart farm. And we have actually identified that in every week, we generate 120 crates of egg.
120 crates?
Yes. 120 crates of egg every week.